Hello everyone, once again I welcome you in this session. In this video, we are going to practice the practice set 3.2. So let's study the first example which is given on the board. Write the correct numbers in the given boxes from the following AP. This given sequence is in AP. What is the definition of AP? AP means the diffs. If you take any two consecutive numbers, any two closest numbers, and if you find a difference among them, then you will find out throughout the sequence the difference between any two consecutive number is constant, then that given sequence is in AP. So here, if you observe the difference in between them, it is a 7, and throughout the sequence you will find out the same difference. So let's study the first example, which is based on the activity. So first example, it is given 1 8 15 22. Now here A is value. If it is in AP, sequence is in AP, then first term is nothing but the A's value. So here A means 1. What about T1? T1 means first term. So first term here it shows 1. Means A's value and T1 first term it would be same. Then T2. T2 it gives that A. T3 third term. Third term is 15. Now we have to check the difference. What is the difference in between any two terms? So T2 minus T1. T2 is 8 minus T1. That means 8 minus 1. The answer comes 7. Here T3 minus T2. T3 minus T2. 15 minus 8. That means answer is 7. So here we have got in both the cases D is equal to 7. So given sequence is in AP. Because its common difference between any two consecutive number, it is 7. Example, in this example, 3, 6, 9, 12. So first term, T1 is equal to 3. T2, we have 6. T3, we have 9. T4 is equal to 12. Now, we will take the T2 minus T1. T2 minus T1. That means 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. Then now we'll take these two terms. That means T3 minus T2. So what is now T3? T3 is 9 and T2 is 6. So 9 minus 6 is equal to 3. So if you observe in both the cases, therefore D, common difference is 3. Third example, sequence, if you observe, it is keep on decreasing. Because minus 3, minus 8, minus 13 and minus 18, that means sequence, the terms in the sequence are decreasing order. So in this case, T1 is equal to minus 3. Second term, T2 is equal to minus 8. T3 is equal to minus 13. T4 is equal to minus 18. So we will check it. T2 minus T1. T2 minus T1 means minus 8. Here students we have to take care. Because of this minus sign. So minus 8 minus minus 3. So minus 8 minus minus it will become plus 3. And you will get the answer minus 5. So T2 minus T1 is equal to minus 5. So T3 minus T2. So minus 13 minus minus 8. T3's value is minus 13. T2's value is minus 8. If you solve it, minus 13 plus 8 and then answer will be minus 5. So you can observe here D is constant. And what is A? A's, they have asked the A's value. And before I have explained you that in AP, the first term is nothing but A's value. So therefore, A is equal to, what is A? A would be first term, that means minus 3. And D would be, the answer is minus 5. Next example, also order of the sequence is in decreasing order. So we'll consider T1 is equal to 70, T2 is equal to 60, T3 is equal to 50, T4 is equal to 40 value. So for that we have to take the T2 minus T1. So T2 minus T1 is equal to 60 minus 70. Here you will get the answer minus 10. Next, we'll check the T3 minus T2 is equal to 50 minus 60, and you will get the answer negative 10. So here, students, A's value is nothing but the first term. First term is given 70, so here it is 70. Now, what is the value of D? D is nothing but minus 10. Second example, in this example, they have given the sequence and we have to decide it whether this sequence is an AP. If it is an AP, then we have to find out the 20th term by using the formula Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So, let's study the example. Solution. Students, now I want to check whether this is an AP. So, for that, what is the definition of an AP? The definition of an AP is that if you take the any two terms and if you find out throughout the sequence, if the difference between any two terms, if it is same, then you can say that this sequence is an AP. For example, suppose if I have taken 2, 9, the difference between them, afterward if I take the difference between these 23 and 30, and if the difference, if you find, if it is same, then you can say that the given sequence is in AP. So, we'll see the solution. T1 is equal to minus 12. So, first I'll assign the terms. T1, 12. T2, minus 5. T3 is equal to 2. T4 is equal to 9. And so on. I'll take the first two terms. T2. Minus T1. What is T2? Minus 5. Minus T1. T1 is given minus 12. So if you solve it, you will get minus 5 minus minus plus plus 12. And answer is nothing but difference is 7. Means these two terms have the difference 7. Now I will take the next term minus previous term. So T3 minus T2. Is equal to T3 is 2 minus T2 is minus 5. So again 2 plus 5, answer is 7. Check for the third and fourth term, that means next term T4 minus previous term, that means T2. So T4 is nothing but 9 minus T3 is 2. So 9 minus 2, answer is 7. So, here we have observed that throughout the sequence, the difference is same. Therefore, common difference is constant. So, therefore, given sequence is an AP. If it is an AP, we have to find out the nth term. Means nth term by using the Tn's formula. Here nth term, that means they told you to find out the 20th term. So I am going to use the formula Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. By putting the values, Tn, we have to put the n's value is 20. A is nothing but the first term, that means minus 12 plus n. I want to find out the 20th term. So, here n's value would be 20. 20 minus 1 into D. Common difference is 7 into 7. So, as per the Podemos rule, we have to solve the bracket first and then multiplication and then addition and subtraction. So, minus 12 plus 20 minus 1 is 19 multiplied by 7. Now I am going to solve this one. T20 is equal to minus 12 as it is plus 19 sevens are 133. Here they have the difference sign. So you have to do the subtraction. If you subtract it, you will get the answer 3 minus 2, 1. Here it is 1, 2. And minus sign, so here it will be, therefore T20 is equal to 121. example, in this example, the given sequence is in AP. If it is in AP, of course, the common difference between any two terms, it's constant. Now, we have to find out the T24 by using the formula Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So, let's study. So, solution. Given sequence 12, 16, 20, 24. So, here T1 is equal to 12, T2 is equal to 16, T3 is equal to 20, T4 is equal to 24. This sequence is in AP, so D would be T2 minus T1. T2 is 16 minus T1 is 12, that means common difference is 4. So, here we have got the value of D. Now, we have to find out T24 by using the formula Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Tn, now I want to find out T24, 24th term, that means n's value would be 24. A value is nothing but the first term, so that means 12 plus n's value T24. I want to find out nth term. Nth term, 24th term. So, n's value would be 24. So, 24 minus 1 into common difference is 4. 12 plus 24 minus 1 is 23. Multiply by 4. First, multiply these two numbers. So, you will get 3, 4 is 12. 3, 4 to the 8 plus 1, 9. So, answer would be 4 and 9 plus 1, 10. So, therefore, T24's value would be 104. Fourth example, in this example, again the AP is given, the sequence is in AP and we have to find out the 19th term. Solution, T1 is equal to 7 for this sequence. T2 is equal to 13, T3 is equal to 19, and T4 is equal to 27. We have to find out 19th term. So, here first term is nothing but A's value. So first, we will find out D. D is equal to T2 minus T1. T2 is 13 minus T1 is 7. 13 minus 7 is 6. By using the formula, Tn is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Here, Tn means T, 19. N's value is 19. A is given 7 plus N. N is 19. So, 19 minus 1 and D. D means nothing but 6. So, 7 plus subtraction, and then you have to multiply. 7 plus, we have to multiply. 18 6 is 108. After adding this, you will get the answer 115. Means T19 value is 115. In this fifth example, we have to find out the 27th term. T1 is equal to 9. T2 is equal to 4, T3 is equal to minus 1, T4 is equal to minus 11. So, A is nothing but the first term is equal to 9. D's value is T2 minus T1, that means 4 minus 9 is equal to. So, here you will get the difference is negative 5. Here we have got the D's value is negative 5. 1, we have got the negative 5 because if you observe the sequence, sequence is in decreasing order. Now we will find out the T27 by using the formula A plus N minus 1 into D. T27, N's value is 27, A is 9 plus N again 27. Minus 1 into D. D is nothing but minus 5. So, 9 plus 27 minus 1 is 26 into minus 5. If you will multiply here, then multiplication would be negative. And the answer comes 130. And if you subtract these two, you will get the answer negative 121. So therefore, T27 is equal to minus 121. Sixth example. In this sixth example, they have said that for how many three-digit natural numbers are divisible by 5? Here sequence is not given. Here we have to prepare the sequence. Now to prepare the sequence, first we will see what is the three-digit numbers. So three-digit numbers which are starts from 100 and it ends at 999. So this is the first three-digit number and this one is the last three-digit number. But one more condition they have given. You have to make the list of those three-digit numbers which are divisible by 5. So of course we'll check it. The first three-digit numbers, it is divisible by 5. But the last three-digit number, it is not divisible by 5. So which number comes before that? So which is divisible by 5? So if you know, then 995, which is divisible by 5 and it is a three-digit number. So here I have got the first number and the last number. So therefore, the sequence of three digit numbers divisible by 5. So first number I have written 100. So how I will get the second number? Second number would be 105. Third term 110. Fourth term. So in this way we have total the numbers up to 995. Now they have said how many numbers are there? So from 100 till 995, how many three-digit numbers are there? So which are divisible by 5. So to get it, so here we have A is equal to 100, D is equal to T2 minus T1. T2 is 105, T1 is 100, that means the difference is 5. Last term is 995. So last term we are going to denote it by Tn. So 995. Now what we have to find out, how many numbers are there? That means we have to find out the n's value. So by using the same formula, Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Tn, it is given 995 is equal to a is 100. N is unknown, that I'll keep it as it is, minus 1 into D. D is 5. Here, we have to multiply inside the bracket by 5. So, 100 plus, you will get 5N minus 5. So, if you observe, 100 minus 5, it is 95. 95 plus 5N and here 995 would be as it is. All three terms are divisible by 5. So I'll divide this by 5. So I will get 5 9s are 199. If you divide this by 5, we will get 9, 5 ones are 9. Plus, if you divide this by 5, here only n will left. Now, 19 transfer it on this side. So, 199 minus 19 is equal to n's value. 99 minus 9, 0. 9 minus 1, it is 8. And here it is 1. So, n is equal to, therefore, n is equal to 180.